There are plenty of mistakes to be made when cooking omelets, and we're all guilty of making them. But once you learn all the ways you're making omelets wrong, you'll be well on your way to making the best omelet of your life. Use these tips and tricks for the perfect omelet every time. You've pulled your ingredients out of the fridge and lined them up on the countertop like good little soldiers. Then you reach for your trusty frying pan. And here's the hitch. If it isn't the right size, you're setting yourself up for failure. The folks at kitchen accessory company Whiskware have this to say. Ask any chef, and you'll find a pretty tight consensus that crafting the perfect omelet starts with the right number of eggs and the right size frying pan. The issue is that using too large of a pan leads to a paper-thin omelet. To avoid winding up with a wimpy dish, Whiskware recommends sticking with a 7-to-8-inch frying pan. So while size may not matter everywhere...
What's his favorite food?
Sandwiches.
Best friend's name?
Probably John.
Eye color.
Dreamy.
Foot size?
Foot size doesn't matter.
It kinda does when you're cooking omelets. Keep that in mind and grab a pan that will live up to your, omelets expectations. Raise your hand if you had no idea you were supposed to separate your egg whites out when making an omelet. Apparently, this is an important step to achieving nirvana in omelet form. To make a super fluffy souffléed omelet, you need to give the egg whites some proper attention. Lifehacker's food and beverage editor Claire Lower said, "Whip the whites with a pinch of salt until stiff peaks form and incorporate half of the mixture into the yolks with a whisk. Gently fold in the rest of the whites, spread into a pan, top with shredded cheese, cover, and cook for 3 minutes." The Incredible Egg, the spoke site for the humble egg itself, explains the logic behind this separation. The site says that fat from egg yolk will prevent egg whites from beating properly. When separating eggs, take care that no yolk gets in the whites. The site suggests you should separate each egg white into a cup or small bowl before dropping it into the mixer bowl. Should you get even a speck of yolk in the white, toss it. Who knew? Let us preface this by saying, it's your life, you do you. Having said that, there are times when we can benefit from the expertise of others, and cooking omelets is one such time. Let food writer Karen Liu serve as a cautionary tale. Once upon a time, he couldn't make an omelet without it devolving into a sort of strange egg stir-fry. In a 2014 article for Food Network, though, Liu revealed he finally kicked his too-many-toppings habit. He said that his best tip for omelet success is only using up to 3 toppings at 1/3 cup each, or a half cup if you're only using 2 toppings. His prior method of tossing in anything in the fridge that struck his fancy turned out to be a major saboteur. Liu explained, "Loading your omelet with too much stuff would result in the egg ripping and becoming more of a scramble." Liu has one more piece of advice about toppings. Cook them accordingly. In other words, size up which take longer to cook than others. Sauté ingredients like mushrooms, onion, bacon, broccoli, and bell peppers before you start your eggs. Liu advised, "I've had many hotel omelets when I'd bite into the eggs and taste raw mushrooms in the center. Don't do that." What's the saying? 2 eggs are better than 1? Okay, so maybe that's not quite how it goes. But if you ask any omelet expert, they'll likely say the same thing. Take, for example, Lacey Beyer, the author at A Sweet Pea Chef. In her pursuit to discover the perfect egg-to-topping ratio, she pinpointed what she considers to be the ideal number of eggs to use in an omelet. She said on her blog, "We all want to cut breakfast prepping time in half, but making a big omelet and splitting it is not a good idea. You will end up with scrambled eggs instead of an omelet because flipping a huge omelet is not easy." Not to mention, Beyer points out, the more eggs you use, the more likely it is that some of those eggs will end up undercooked. Her advice? Start with 2 eggs. You can always add another egg white if you want to up your protein intake. Beyer notes that you can, of course, crack a 3rd egg if you're feeling ravenous. However, any more than 3 is overkill and merits a 2nd omelet. Who among us hasn't whipped up an omelet using whatever ingredients we have on hand in the fridge? Whether it's the last few eggs in the carton or leftover steamed broccoli, you can't beat readily available ingredients for convenience. But just because you have them on hand doesn't mean they're going to give you a great omelet experience. In fact, Southern Living believes, quote, "the fresher the better" should be your rule of thumb when it comes to making a killer omelet. The folks at Southern Living said, "Fresh eggs make a world of difference when it comes to this breakfast staple." If you're an avid farmer's market shopper, you'll be able to see the color difference in straight-from-the-farm eggs compared to store-bought ones. Fresh local eggs usually have vibrant yellow-orange yolks, and your omelet will be much tastier and colorful because of it. The same logic applies to your omelets, fillings, and toppings as well, so be sure to reach for those farm-fresh eggs and fresh produce next time an omelet craving hits. Where Alton Brown leads, we shall follow. So when the Good Eats creator / Iron Chef America commentator / best-selling cookbook author says we're messing up an important part of the omelet-making process, we take note. Not surprisingly, Brown is a wealth of knowledge when it comes to whipping up this delectable dish, but it's one particular piece of advice he offers that is low-key brilliant. He said in Food Network magazine that you should heat your pan empty for a few minutes before adding the butter. Even a nonstick surface is pocked with microscopic pores that eggs can fill and grab hold of. Heat expands the metal, squeezing these openings shut. Mind blown, right? You should have your sauté pan over medium to high heat. You'll also need to set aside 10 seconds after you begin cooking the eggs to let your omelet sit untouched to develop a proper outer crust.
I really like my omelet to not be too cooked, and it just comes out and it's not too brown on top. You know, and actually these are even a little too brown for my taste.
But when all is said and done, Brown said, quote, "Your patience will be rewarded." To some of us, butter is butter is butter. It's all good, and we'll take extra, please and thank you.
Every time you taste something that's delicious beyond imagining, and you say, "What is in this?" the answer is always going to be butter.
However, and this may sound like sacrilege, there is such a thing as using the wrong butter. Such is the case when making an omelet. Domestic goddess Martha Stewart deemed it so. In a 1997 issue of Martha Stewart Living, the maven made it clear that certain types of butter are undesirable for omelets because they're prone to burning. Stewart said, "Use clarified butter, which does not burn as quickly as salted or unsalted butter. If you do use regular butter, watch carefully to keep it from burning. Just think of clarified butter as liquid gold, as in not only is it worth its weight in gold in the culinary world, but it quite literally looks like the molten precious metal too. Although you're likely most familiar with seeing it used as a dipping sauce for lobster and other high-priced crustaceans, clarified butter boasts tons of versatility in the kitchen due to its very high smoke point. And that's why this beautiful butterfat, void of milk solids, is ideal for making omelets. An omelet's most winning trait, besides taste of course, could arguably be that it's relatively quick and easy to create. Whether you were hungry before you started making it, or the smell of it cooking kicked your hunger into overdrive, you're always grateful that you can churn out an omelet in no time. But here's the thing, if you really want it to be the best omelet it can be, you're going to need to practice a bit of restraint.
I've come to a decision. This one is the clear winner.
Yes! Smash five!
Most of us presumably cook an omelet until the eggs are cooked all the way through. And while this seems like a sound approach, BBC Food recommends a different route. They said you should remove the pan from the heat while the egg is still slightly runny in the middle. The residual heat will cook the egg. Residual heat for the win. When you slide into a booth at IHOP and order an omelet, you know that what comes out of that kitchen is going to be a light-as-air blanket of eggs hugging cheese and other delicious fillings. On more than one occasion, you may even have wondered how the breakfast chain managed to make their omelet so gosh darn fluffy. Well, friends, as you suspected, IHOP has a secret ingredient. What you probably didn't expect is that their secret ingredient is pancake batter. It really is a house of pancakes. The Daily Mail revealed, by adding a small amount of pancake batter to its eggs, IHOP accomplishes a few things. One, it adds some structure to the eggs, making them a little more sturdy and filling. Two, the extra moisture leads to a fluffier overall product. And three, it adds just the slightest amount of tasty pancake flavor to the mix. This means that somewhere along the way, someone in IHOP's kitchen did some serious outside-of-the-box, or better yet, inside-of-the-pancake-box thinking when cooking an omelet. And the result is a dish that is delightful and distinctive in equal measure. Moral of the story? Don't be afraid to experiment while endeavoring to create the perfect omelet, because you might just stumble upon your own very special star ingredient. Bet you didn't realize so much went into making an omelet, huh? While cooking an omelet is an art form, let it be said that getting too lost in the inner workings of making an omelet can have effects just as disastrous as ignoring all of the advice cataloged here. The Pioneer Woman's blog said as much, so it must be true. In an article on Drummond's popular site in 2016, food blogger Erica Leah confessed that her first few attempts at making omelets turned out to be a disaster. She could pinpoint her main issues easily enough: too much milk in her eggs, too much filling, and trying to make her omelets look fancy enough for a dinner table. Yet it took her a hot minute to connect the dots. She said, "I finally realized that I was overcomplicating things, so I simplified my process, and suddenly my omelet game improved immensely." Leah's pared-down but winning method entails 2 eggs with a little salt, well whisked with a fork, a decent gob of butter, and a handful of cheese paired with a few pre-cooked fillings like mushroom and bacon, and a carefully timed fold. That's pretty much it. The moral of the story? When in doubt, keep it simple. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Mashed videos about cooking tips are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.